If there's one thing that every video game has in common, it's their brutal boss battles. The first game to actually ever have a boss battle was a game called D&D back in 1975. There's plenty of iconic video game boss battles, but today we're going to be looking at the iconic franchise of Resident Evil.
You want stars? I'll give you stars.
So, from flying bats to shooting hats, this is the top 5 hardest Resident Evil boss fights. I've heard many people complain about the bat boss fight in Resident Evil Zero. And when I've played this game for myself, I've truly found that it is really hard to use the grenade launcher against the bat because it lacks the spread that the shotgun has, which means that it's really hard to actually hit a precise shot on the bat. His ability to fly around gives him insane mobility, and with his little bats that he has that keep stunning you repeatedly, it can make this a very frustrating boss fight. Pretty much every boss fight in Resident Evil Code Veronica X is hard in its own right. The Tyrant on the Plane, Nosferatu, Alexia's Flame Fight, Steve, and the final Alexia boss fight are all easily the hardest boss fights in Resident Evil history. This part can be really frustrating in particular just because of the little baby mutants that are coming your way that keep stunning you and taking your health away. After successfully completing that stage of the Alexia boss fight, it gets even harder. Now you are gifted a linear rocket launcher that has infinite ammo. But what truly makes this part challenging is trying to hit Alexia while she's flying around and whilst using tank controls. The linear rocket launcher is actually a really unique looking plasma launcher, but with the way it makes sense in terms of Resident Evil, I don't know why it was there. If it's a weapon that could take down Alexia in her final form with just one shot, then why would they have it displayed right there for us? Regardless, the linear rocket launcher is quite hard to use, and if you can't hit her in one shot before the time ends, or before she kills you, it'll be a straight up game over. And there's a good chance that your most previous save will be quite far away, resulting in you having to start over and try it all again.
Yeah.
What the hell's going on?
Sorry, William. You left me no choice.
For me, coming in at number 3 is the Stage 3 William Birkin fight from Resident Evil 2 Remake, also known as the Third Form Birkin fight. I've seen a lot of people speculate that the Super Tyrant fight at the end of Resident Evil 2 Remake Leon scenario is debatably the hardest boss fight in this game, but I think otherwise. This Birkin fight has gotten me killed on several occasions while doing speedruns and hardcore runs. So I think this Birkin fight in particular is easily the hardest boss fight for me on Resident Evil 2 Remake. Your first objective is to make sure you shoot all 3 of his eyeballs that are displayed on his body. One on his arm, one on his leg, and one on his back. After you've done that sequence twice, you will then get him to expose his big set of eyeballs in the middle of his chest or stomach area. This is a good indicator to know that you've got him pretty weakened and that you're reaching the end states of his health bar. At this point in the fight, you would want to use any kind of weapon that does fire damage. So for Leon, it would be the flamethrower, and for Claire, it would be the grenade launcher with the flame rounds. I have never found this fight to be very easy, even when you know what kind of weapons deal the most type of damage to him. And also, from what I've heard, Claire's scenario is much more difficult than Leon's scenario, as Claire gets different weapons than Leon does, and her spark shot and grenade launchers tend to not do as much damage as Leon's flamethrower or shotgun. Regardless though, I spent about the first year or two that Resident Evil 2 Remake was out just trying to speedrun and get the fastest times on this game, just to simply get killed to this Birkin fight time after time again, and then having my entire run just absolutely ruined. But when you finally get that last shot off and you get to see his death animation, that's when the big sigh of relief comes over you, and that's when reality sets in that that part is behind you and is now in the past. Coming in at number 2 is definitely one of the scariest and most tense boss fights in all of Resident Evil. The Saddler boss fight in Resident Evil 4 Separate Ways I think is one of the most challenging boss fights where you're fighting a boss that's just in his human form. Osmond Saddler just in his human form is debatably stronger and faster than Wesker in his human form.
Are you trying to make me angry?
Now, some of you may think that the Saddler boss fight in RE4 Remake Separate Ways was harder than this one in the original Separate Ways, but the only reason I didn't include that one and I included this one instead is because in RE4 Remake you're able to buy the RPG much easier than in the original RE4 Separate Ways. Them making the price of the RPG exceptionally lower in Separate Ways was just the game trying to help newer players get through some of these boss fights easier, and in the original RE4, they were not handing out cheap RPGs like that. In the original RE4, Saddler has a lot of attacks that require QTEs to be able to dodge them, which stand for quick time events, which is when the buttons pop up on screen super fast, and if you don't hit them in time, well, then you are dead. There's a lot of good strategies that you can use in the original RE4 Separate Ways to defeat Saddler, with the best strategy possibly being the sniper rifle, because it's able to stun Saddler pretty good, and it's also able to keep him at bay and keep him pretty far away from you. Now, of course, the crossbow is another good weapon to have for Saddler, but it's hard to get a lot of arrows in your playthrough, so you gotta make sure you've got ammo if you're gonna be using it. This Saddler boss fight is the last boss fight that's holding you back from being able to beat the game on the original RE4 Separate Ways, and if you don't have enough ammo to do it, then you're not gonna be beating the game. That factor right there is what makes this boss fight so hard for me, at least. That and also having to use QTEs mid-boss fight is something that made this really hard for me in my earlier years of playing Resident Evil games.
What about you?
We're running out of time. I've got this.
I know you do.
Look, just so you know, this is the last fucking time.
Depending on what difficulty you're talking about, the final Nemesis fight in Resident Evil 3 Remake can always be quite challenging. When I wanted to make my top 5 hardest Resident Evil boss battles, I wanted to do it with the intention of having each boss battle on its hardest difficulty, and with this one, it was debatably the hardest boss fight I've ever had to do on the game's hardest difficulty, which was called Inferno Mode. The goal of this boss fight is to push the 3 power sources back into the wall and have him stunned long enough to be able to do so. With all that being said, this can be a really hard boss fight to do, even if you have the infinite rocket launcher, all of the coins in the game, and the manual for dodging. Most players' advice was to just learn how to dodge and just have good RNG when you go into it. When I tried to play Infernal Mode and I made it to the final Nemesis fight, I learned that RNG wasn't much of a factor, and for what I had to do, I had to simply get better at the dodging and be more aware of his attack animations. You literally have to be able to dodge every little slap that he does, or else if he hits you once, you better heal, or else you're just gonna be dying over and over again. Just like any difficult boss battle, after enough hard work and rethinking your strategy, you'll be able to conquer Nemesis in all of his forms and finally take down this game on its hardest difficulty.
Come on! Next time, take the fucking hit!
That is gonna conclude my top 5 hardest Resident Evil boss fights. Let me know down in the comments below what you think is the hardest boss fight in all of Resident Evil. Do you think it's Irving? Do you think it's Mother Miranda? Or do you think it's Morpheus? I believe I can fly. For real though guys, thank you so much for watching and for sticking this long into the video. If you did stick this long into the video, let me know if your guys' team won the Super Bowl this year. Or, if not, if your team even made the Super Bowl this year. Either way, sound off in the comments, and I'll be replying to every single comment. I really enjoy doing these top 5 or top 10 kind of videos, but I don't get around to doing them that often. If you do want to watch my uploads every day, then make sure you stick around for my Resident Evil Reverse gameplay that I post daily. If you want to help me on my journey to hit 1,000 subscribers, then please consider hitting subscribe and joining me on my journey to 1,000 subs. All of the support lately has been greatly appreciated, and with that being said, I hope to see you guys all in the next video tomorrow. Peace.
But just take a look at this. It's Forrest. Oh my God.